Welcome to RP Hub. In this video, we'll discuss about other topic on Power BI. We'll see here how to apply filter. So this is video number 13 in this playlist. If you have not started from the initials, I would request you to go through all the videos from the beginning so that you will not miss important concept. Here, the idea is to give you a detailed insight about the Power BI so that you'll be able to understand each and everything in detail and you'll utilize this knowledge for your enterprise projects. And as I committed, the end of the sessions, I will also distribute you certificates which might help you in your career. Because I'm adding a lot of efforts, I'm expecting from you to share this content as much as possible, because if you'll go through on other paid platforms, same contents people are selling with cost. Here, I'm putting a lot of efforts to make this video, so I would request you to add feedback about this content and share as much as possible. Let's start with today's content. Here, I will show you in both way, in cloud and desktop both version, so that you will not miss anything. Whenever you have generated a visuals on cloud, you will see this is the filter options available. Select any of the charts or visuals and here you will get filters. Now, you can see I am having lot of people name because this chart is presenting count of supermarket sales data by column 3. Here, whatever purchaser name I will add, those purchaser name will be added successfully. This is I'm doing for filtering, or this is I'm applying the filter where I can see individuals buyer name. That's filter options. It means narrowing the content from Power BI so that we can see each and every information in detail. If I want to remove the filters, I will uncheck everything and we can see the complete data available. Similar way, we can also apply the filter in count of supermarkets. As of now, we have selected all, but you can even apply less than or equal to with some number. Let's consider I'm giving just one. Apply this filter. Here we can see less than or equal to number of buyer. If I will just change this number to, then I will have the numbers or the buyer list generated less than or equal to 2. Similarly, we can apply any other filter. Whenever you are fine, you can just add all those informations, remove it. That's it, and you will have the complete data available. Here you can also remove any filter which is applied on just clicking on this icon where we are clearing the filter. Let's go to the other charts and see the records. Here this time I'm selecting with this one and we have the filter available. Navigating it to the desktop versions, whenever you will select any charts, you will see these filters are available. Here the data is different. Now I'm applying the filter on number of issue counts. Similar way, we can also apply based on the priority. Let's consider I'm interested just in the high priority issues, because this data contains Jira issues. That's reason I am calling it out issues. In desktop versions, here whenever I wanted to just apply the filter on all, I will select all, else maybe I'm just interested to see high or highest issues which is present in my visuals. This is how we can apply the filter, and based on this filter we'll get our data available in front of us. It's a very easy and quicker way where we can narrow down all those informations which is present in any Power BI dashboards, and this will help us make us understand which type of data we are interested to see. Similar way, we can also add some other filters. Like here, we have add data fields here, filters on all pages. Similarly, we can apply the filters in all those categories. Depending on the data sets, depending on the informations, whichever you have, you will see these filters carry additional informations as well. That's all for this video. Hope you enjoyed the content. If you think so, this will be useful, don't forget to share within your circle. Just one of your efforts might change the life of your near and dear one. So I would request you share this video with your close connections so that they can also leverage it without paying anything. They will get complete learning from this playlist, where they will get a chance to add additional skill set into their resume. So that's all for today's video. Hope you enjoyed it. We'll see you in further part of the playlist. Thank you.